lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you 5 looks and give my opinion on the newest palette by Beauty Bay called The Love Notes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 46, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to learn how to apply makeup on a face that is no longer as plump and supple as it was kind of 20 years ago, and if you just want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Yes, what is also kind of important in today's video is that I am a light warm olive. And why do I say that? Because shadows tend to warp on me. So it could very well be that you see one color in the pan and that you see it kind of transforming on my eye, because I'm kind of like that. Let me tell you a tiny, tiny little bit about the palette. Love Notes palette by Beauty Bay's own brand. It is a 20 color palette. The palette is vegan and cruelty free, and it says here, step into a hazy daze and become obsessed with the Love Notes palette, featuring 20 shades that are wearable for every day whilst still allowing you to get creative. You're going to fall in love with this palette time after time, time after time. Ranging from soft lavenders to playful florals and sparkly pinks, let us introduce you to your new makeup suitor. I will show you 5 looks. I will go row by row, like that, because I think that a lot of people will focus on more monochromatic looks, and I kind of wanted to do something different because I like to do that. So yeah, timestamps for the different looks will be listed down below. I have done more videos with the Beauty Bay palettes. That playlist will be listed in the description box, and I will show you some swatches and give my opinion at the end of the video. If you want to skip all the looks, I don't know why you would, but if you want to skip all the looks, just click the review timestamp down in the description box. Yeah, let's just grab a drink and a snack and put your feet up and enjoy, because here comes look number 1. I am going to start with a shade called Lilac. I'm using the Natasha Denona eyeshadow base today. And it is not set. Then I'm going to go to the shade Mahogany, following my bottom lid up. I place it and then I pull it in. It is a brown and it has a little bit of red in it. It should mix, no problem. Switching brushes to blend. Cleaning the brush, then going to go back to the shade Lilac. I'm going to blend it in a bit. I want that shade Mahogany underneath my eye as well. I'm loading up the brush, I'm spraying it to make it a bit more intense and to help against fallout. And then I'm just going to follow my bottom lid, stamping it on. Oh, it's on the outer part. Actually going to use the same technique to darken it up a little bit on the outer corner. For the inner eye part area, I'm going to go to the shade Corset. Lower lash line, I'm going to spray that as well. And I'm going to press it on my lower lash line in the inner part. Let's grab a little bit of the shade Corset to put here. Then I'm going to go to the shimmer. And that is going to be the shade Pillow. A very creamy shade. Tipping off my brush, I'm going to try dry first. Okay, I'm going to spray it. So I'm loading up my brush, then I'm spraying my brush, and I'm pressing the shadow on my eye. It looks like it has a putty texture when I press my brush in. I don't know if that's helpful, but I do have shadow underneath. I have eyeshadow underneath. We will see if it creases. I will try to pay more attention to that to see if this creases or not. It's very cute though. I kinda do want to have a little bit of shine on my lower lash line, so I'm going to go to the shade Candlestick. So I'm going to spray that as well. For inner corner, I am going to go to the shade Chandelier. This is a drier formula. Oh, that's pretty. And this appears to have a shift in it. Okay, I'm going to finish off the look and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with a lip liner from ColourPop in the shade BFF. Yes. And then a lippy from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Sand Nudes. Falsies are the Iconics from House of Lashes. And this is how I am going to look for the rest of the day. I really do like it. Let me know down below what you think of this look. Let's get ready for look number two. The second look. I'm going to start with the shade called Cotton. With a dense brush. This is a shade that is so close to my skin tone. That I really have to pack it on. The base I'm using is the ABH base, which is very, very light. So I'm going to go to a brush that's a little bit fluffier. Same color. I do want a hint of definition, so I'm going to go back to the shade that I used yesterday, which was the shade Mahogany. The darkest. Very, very lightly, because I kind of want to have a little bit. If I don't have definition in my crease and outer corner, it looks weird. I'm dipping between the two, Mahogany and Cotton. So I want it a little bit higher here. Okay, bottom lid. I'm going to go to the shade Lavender. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to pack it on my bottom lid. I'm going to pull it on my top lid. Then I'm going to go to the shade Spark. I'm going to spray that too. And that's going to go on top. On my upper lid, I'm going to use the shade Candlestick. Choose a dry first. Oh, that's pretty. Okay, I'm going to go with the other side to the shade Spank, which was that purpley shimmer.
It's also dry, I'm just fading it over.
Okay, back to the shade Lavender. I'm going to put it on top of the shimmer a little bit, because it's more of that pink tone now, because the shimmer is more pink toned. A little bit cooler. Okay, for inner corner, I'm going to go to the shade Candlelight. Bigger brush, but that's okay. Going to pull it up a little as well. So let me finish off the look and then I'll be right back. I finished off the look with my favorite falsies from Babydoll in the style 723. The eye pencil I have in my waterline is from Catrice. It's an ultra precision in the shade Mauve. And of course they're emptying trash cans right now, but it is the way it is. I will talk a little louder. On my lips is ColourPop lippy pencil in the shade BFF. I filled the lips in as well, and then I used Manny's gloss in shade Coven from Lunar Beauty. And then that is it for look number two. It is a little bit more, I want to say almost a little bit more bottom heavy, because I wanted to have the accent a little bit more on the bottom, because I knew it would kind of be balanced with the falsies that I am wearing. Yeah, let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for look number three. I am going to start with a shade called Glove. Okay, I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush, but a little bit dense still.
Just to make sure that that outer corner is packed on the way that I want it to.
Got to blend the edges a little before I go in with the next shade. Next shade is going to be the shade called Soap. Oh, I need to pack it in my inner corner a little bit first, I think, which is fine. I'm just going to blend it into the other layer. Blend the shades together a bit. So Basically, because I'm blending this shade over, I'm cooling the purple down a bit. Make it less pink and more purple on me at least. I'm going over with that darker purple. A little bit more of the shade Soap in the beginning around my tear duct. I'm going to go to the shade Princess. This is dry because here on the outer part I wanted to pick up on the matte shade that I have. I'm just lightly brushing it over. That's why I'm starting in the center of my eye and then brushing it back. What I'm going to do is I'm going to layer it on top of the matte I have decided. So I'm going to go back to the shade Soap. I'm going to go back to the previous, to the Shimmer Princess. This was dry. Let's spray and see what it does. And it gets a little bit more metallic. Okay. Let's go back to the shade Glove. Just with the tip of this brush, actually, I'm really looking down. And I want to blend it a little bit in the crease. If I can, if my eye wants to cooperate. A little bit on the outer corner. And then the shade Soap. I'm also pulling that on top of the shimmer in the inner corner. It should not really take away from the shine. But I want it a little bit lighter there. The eye pencil I'm using is from NYX. Frosted Lilac, I believe. Okay, inner corner is going to be the shade Chandelier. Okay, this is it so far. Let me finish off the look and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with Falsies from Babydoll in style 723. On my lips is the Unearthly Cosmetics Satin Liquid Lipstick in the shade Diana, topped with a gloss in the shade Purple Unicorn from DJ's Unique Beautique. Yes. I like how it turned out. I like it a lot. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number 4. Look number 4. And it's going to be a pretty soft look today. I'm going to start with the shade Handkerchief. Oh, that's a pretty shade. I am packing it on. But it's a very nice bright pink. Okay, then I'm going to go to the shade Angel and I'm going to blend out the pink. And I'm going to put it a little bit in the inner eye part area as well. That hot pink is also going to go on my lashes. And I do want to deepen it up, but I don't want it to look too much like the look for tomorrow. So I am actually grabbing a fluffy brush and a shade called Glove, which is a darker purple. I'm going to very lightly deepen up the outer corner and the crease. Then I'm going to go back to the hot pink called Handkerchief. I want a little bit of definition in my outer corner on my lower lashes, so I'm grabbing a little bit of that purple on a very, very tiny brush. And I'm just lightly coating my lashes. And putting it a little bit more heavily on the outer corner of my mobile lid. I think what I want to do is kind of clean up my lid a little. For that I'm not grabbing a glitter primer, I'm actually grabbing an eye primer. This one is from Catrice, but it's one that stays very, very sticky for a very, very long time. And I'm just going to basically look down, follow my eyeball. I'm going to go to the shade Bellini. This is such a pretty color. I'm really packing it on my brush and I'm not going to spray, but I'm going to press it in that primer as best as I can. And I'm swiping in all the directions to make sure that it's in all the creases. and such. Oh, this is cutesy. I feel like a candy.
Top of that purple, I'm just going to brush it on a little. And I'm going to grab a little bit of that purple.
And on that same fluffy brush.
And blend it a little bit over. And then a hint in the crease. Then I'm going to go back to the hot pink. And I'm basically going to do the same thing. But a little bit more in the middle.
And then the other shimmer I have left, I want underneath my eye.
I'm actually also going to put this in the outer corner, more on top of the purple. And then I'm going to go back to the previous, to the other shimmer, and brush that over a little so that they mix.
Inner corner highlight is going to be the shade Chandelier. Kind of want to use that one on its own as well, but I haven't yet.
Let's also be fancy and put it underneath the brow bone. Okay, here is the look so far. I'm going to finish it off and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with half lashes from Viv in the style Schmokey. Lippy is from Madage Beauty London in the shade Mirage, which has a light sparkle in it. And I forgot an eye pencil, I just realized. But that is all okay. It happens sometimes. I really like how this look turned out. Let me know down below what you think of it. Oh yeah, and I also used the hot pink, which was the shade Handkerchief, as a blush today to tie everything together. Yes, this was it for look number 4, right? Yes, let's get ready for look number 5. I am going to start with the shade called Ruby, I think. Following my bottom lid up and in. I'm switching to a brush that I can blend with. Cleaning it on the towel and I'm blending the edges. A little bit up, but mostly in. A hint of the color. I'm trying a different eye base today, so I kind of need to learn how to work with the base a little bit. Tapping is the way to go. Okay. Okay. Next shade is going to be the shade... Let's go to Cheeks. I'm going to blend it a little bit more into that darker color. Gives a nice gradient. And then I'm going to go to the lightest shade called Flush. Also going to put this on my lid. Oh, but I kind of need a packing brush for that. Then I'm going to go back to finesse it a little bit. So I'm going to go to the darkest color. And then I'm going to go to the middle color called Cheeks. To just make that gradient very nice. Then I have the shimmer left, but I kind of like it all matte like this. So I'm going to put the shimmer on the lower lash line. I'm going to spray it against Fallout. I'm going to grab the shade Bellini. Spray it. Kind of press it a little bit in the inner part of my lower lash line. For inner corner, I'm going to go to the shade Chandelier. And I think this is going to be it. So yeah, let me finish it off. And then I'll be back to show you the final look and give you my opinion on the palette. I finished off the look with my favorite lashes, the Baby Dolls in 723. Eye pencil is from Glam Shop in the shade Burgundy. Lip pencil is from Catrice in the shade Understated Chic. And on my lips is a gloss from Lunar Beauty in the shade Bitchcraft. I did use a brown eyeliner today from NYX instead of the black that I usually use. I really do like how this turned out. I like that it is a matte look with a little bit of a hint of a sparkle. I also used the shade Flush that I used today as a blush, and I kind of went a little bit extra with the shade Cupid, which is the shimmer that I used today. So this one as a blush, this one as a shimmery toppery blush, hint of it. But yeah, let me give you my opinion on the palette.
I like the color story. I thought it was something a little bit different than the usual color stories that we saw for Valentine's Day. It looks like a very, very pastel light palette, but I do think that I could create a lot of depth with this palette. So I think it's kind of, I don't know, a pastel with a twist, maybe a little bit. You have some neutrals, you have some purpley shades in cool and warmer finishes. And then here you have some rosier, maybe even peachier tones a little bit. I do have to say that I think that if you are tan and up, the lighter shades can potentially look ashy on you. And what do I base that on? I actually base that on packing on the lighter shades on my eyelids. When I see a formula doing, I kind of call it the chalkiness sometimes. It kind of looks almost like there's some type of a dusty layer over it, especially with very light shades. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't happen. When it does happen, I kind of noticed also from the feedback from you guys that those types of shades tend to look ashy on a deep skin tone. So I'm guessing tan, you can still do that. And then if you are darker than that, I think some of them will be ashy. Maybe you can offset that by using a lighter base, but that is what I feel, at least. If I am wrong or right, please let me know down in the comment section. The reason that I went row by row is because I think that a lot of people with this palette will go kind of monochromatic, so will either do a purple look or they will do a pinky look or kind of a look like I did today. But I just wanted to show you how you can mix and match. I think that overall, if you, I don't know, if you want a palette that you can use every day, that you can also use to work, that is soft enough when you want to, so basically from day to night, from, you know, work to date night, something like that, I think this can be the one for you. I do think that this palette is kind of geared a little bit more towards the lighter skin tones, and I think that if you want something a little bit more vibrant, you need the Age of Opulence. Yes, the Book of Magic is kind of smack in the middle. I have a picture on Instagram and I will put it in here where I basically have taken a picture with all three palettes so you can kind of see the difference. I think this is the lightest one. Then I think you get the little bit more of maybe even the vibrancy of the Book of Magic, and then the more darker colors of the Age of Opulence. Now, unfortunately, the Book of Magic is no longer sold. I don't know if the Age of Opulence is still in stock, but I will link down below where you can find it. If I'm not mistaken, this is either brought back already or they will bring it back very soon, because that's what I saw on, I think on Instagram, or did I get an email? I kind of forgot. So let's go to the performance. I think the mattes performed, for me at least, beautifully. I tried them on some different eye bases. I tried them on the ABH eye base. No problems whatsoever. I know that I love this formula with the Natasha Denona primer as well. Today I tried a different primer, which is from, where is it? It's actually new. It's from Makeup Revolution. It's their Prime and Lock. I don't really know how I feel about the primer just yet, but I do think that the shadows performed beautifully on top of it. And this is a little bit more of a concealer consistency, so maybe that is helpful. The shimmers, I paid attention this time. Most didn't crease, some did. So the shade that actually did crease was it the shade Spark? I think it was the shade Spark that kind of creased on me a little bit. But overall, they did not really. Now, what did I do? I usually had, I think it was the only time that I really cleaned up my lid with the eye base. Yeah, that was when it really creased on me. Really, when it creased on me. These shimmers are a little bit more creamy. They tend to crease on me a tad. What you can do to counteract it, what works for me at least, is to put the matte shade underneath to basically soak up a little bit of the creaminess of the shade. I hope that helps. That's kind of what helps for me, but overall, most of the shades did not really crease. Now, I do have to say that a lot of shadows crease on me, especially when it's shitty weather. I live at the Dutch coast. So, you know, when it's a little bit more moist in the air, everything creases. And it does not matter. Unless I have a formula that is extremely sticky, then it tends to stay put. But those are usually a nightmare to put on. So it's either or, you know. But yeah, overall, I did not have a lot of creasing. So maybe that's helpful. Otherwise, maybe it's an idea to I don't want to say pack them then on your eye, but if you are, for instance, want to use this one and you and you're like, maybe it will crease on me, put this one on your eye first and then basically layer this on top. So either use it as a topper so you still get the shine, because the base shades are pretty similar. Can you see that? So, and same with these two. You could even pack it on top of this one if you want it a little bit darker. Maybe that is helpful. I know it creases for some, it doesn't crease for others. Yeah, if you find a formula that just creases a lot, and for instance, if for me it creases here. I have a fold here, it creases there. Then I will just concentrate it on the inner part and then kind of dust it over the rest a little bit. That's also something that I can utilize if I want to. But yeah, I think that the shimmers are very pretty. There are different finishes, as I said. Some are a little bit more creamy, so this one and this one and this one are a little bit more creamy. This one is a little bit of a drier formula, which I don't mind at all. And then, yeah, these here, basically those four here are a little bit more, I don't want to say that they are drier, but there is almost less of a, these two can feel like almost a putty texture. It's not completely true, but I have to kind of explain the difference. So these can kind of feel like a little bit of a putty texture, and these feel less putty. I hope that's helpful. I did not really feel that a lot of the shades warped on me. Now, I don't know if I said so in the beginning. I hope I did, but I'm a light warm olive. That means, and I know that some of you notice that when you see the colors in the pan and then see them on my eye, you see that they are warping. Sometimes it's also with the swatches that I do. So why do I do swatches? I do swatches to feel the shadow. So that I can kind of have a sense of, okay, how do I need to work with it? But to see if they warp a lot on me. And also the eye base that I use underneath can kind of help or offset the warping. So the Anastasia Beverly Hills pulls a little bit more gray pink on me, which kind of helps with some of the cooler tones or maybe even with some of the pinker tones. I think that is it. I felt that the mattes blended beautifully. They packed on beautifully. I could layer. I could basically pack on and then blend out like I did today. The shimmers were stunning and they did not crease on me very much. Honestly, yeah, and I just love the way that they did this. I think it's a very, very nice addition to their lineup, and I think that if you have them all these purpley ones, that you don't have dupes. But again, I did a picture and you have seen it. Let me know down below if you have the palette or if you want the palette. Did this review help? Did I give you some inspiration? Do you now know that you can go ahead and purchase it, or that you're going to walk away from this one? Let me know down below. I will link down below Beauty Base site where you can find the palette. And thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye.